Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Friday. And there has been so much goodness in the studio this week. I hope you have checked a lot of it out. My sisters and I have filmed Start Creating As We Go, where we share what we're creating, and we really got into it this week. We had some really deep conversations, so I hope you'll check that out. I'll leave a link below, and if you're a member of the studio, and I hope you are, if you're not, come on over to openthedoor.ca. You'll get a link to it in the newsletter on Sunday. So that was fantastic. And then yesterday, I hope you have checked out my podcast where I talked to Jean Oliver. And Jean runs a very successful, large, positive, creative network that has tons of classes and resources. And she's a really real and down-to-earth creative woman. And I had such a good time talking to her. And there's things that she shared on the podcast that I'm still thinking about, that are impacting me and how I do my work. And I hope that you'll listen and hear something that impacts you too. I'm also wrapping up the Art of the Altar. We are completing our altars and activating them on Saturday. We've been on an amazing journey through North, South, West, and East. And it has been a magical time. I think perhaps, you know, this summer I was only going to teach 7 soul symbols, and then the Art of the Altar just kept pushing at me, like it wanted me to express it, to be in it this summer. And I almost didn't do it. And it was because I knew it would be demanding to do the both classes this summer. But I'm so glad I did. There's been some magic here. There's been some energy stirring. There's been energy stirring in the group. Some amazing things have happened. Some beautiful expressions of altars have taken shape, but also something is stirring in me, and something is changing, and something is always changing. That's the truth. And at the studio, you know, I have this tendency to fall in love with everything and want to keep it forever. And what that means often, and maybe you've been through this too, it's like you've got one plate spinning, and you get another plate spinning, you get another plate, and you want to keep going and going and going, and you never want to put one down. And so I guess that's my way of saying one of the things I'm thinking about, as I tend to do at the end of every season, as a transition into the next. And certainly once I start getting my eye on the year ahead, is thinking about what stays, what needs to leave in order to make room, like just for a while, just to make room for something else at the table. What kinds of things might those be? And it always feels both exciting and risky, both happy and sad. It is hard to do. And it's hard to know when to do it. And so that is one of the reasons that I believe in creative practices, like journaling every day, like moving your body, like meditating. Because in those practices, I feel like you have the opportunity to stay connected to your deepest self, to hear the gentle, sweet voice of your intuition, to keep your compass clean and straight. You know, sometimes I think that when life is really overly busy, or we're under a great deal of stress, or we have a lot of influences from other people, it is like having a magnet right beside a compass, you know, where it kind of goes a little haywire and isn't really sure where to point. So coming back to your practices, grounding yourself in who you are and what you think, and giving yourself time to have enough space to hear. That's how it works for me. Some people I know really see or really feel in their gut, but I just always sort of feel this sentence drop into my head that tells me this is what to do next, or this is the direction to point my boat. And that takes some time, and that takes some listening, and it takes some tuning in. So for me, as I've mentioned many times, the core creative practices are moving morning pages or, you know, and meditation. These days, I believe that those, I'm a little flexible with what those might look like. So morning pages can be Julia Cameron's 3 pages of longhand freeform writing every morning. But as long as you're journaling, and as long as you're journaling in a way that is free and expressive and gives you a chance to hear your voice, that's a practice that's going to make a difference to you and your creative life. And movement, just moving your body. You can be going to a dance class. It can be going for a walk. It can be doing your physio. It can be doing yoga. It can be just stretching. Just remembering that you have a body and telling your body that you know that it's there keeps you more alive and more vibrant, and also being able to be in conscious conversation with the wisdom that exists here in the cells of your being. And then the other practice I suggest is meditation. This may be a traditional form of meditation where you sit and pay attention to your breath and just let your thoughts dance while you keep focused on that in-breath and that out-breath. And if that's something that's of interest to you, I highly recommend Susan Piver's Open Heart Project. It's a free email where she gives you a meditation each week. It's exactly how I got into meditation. I don't even know. I just was like, I think maybe I should meditate. And Susan was literally just starting this project and I dove in and it's changed my life. But it can also be me time. It can be time on your own without the influence of other people's opinions, of the noise of society and the world. Just meditative walking, meditative doodling, chair and stare time, any of these things that you just get a chance to quietly and completely reconnect with you. And through those practices, I think you tend your creative fire and your creative spirit. For me, one of the whole joys of creativity is it's a way for us to express the uniqueness of this spirit we get to have in this lifetime, you know, with all its quirks, with all its eccentricities, with all its passions, with all its insights, that we can write a poem like nobody else can write, and we can sing a song like nobody else can sing it, and we can design a dress or make a dinner party or paint or draw or anything from this place of being true to the uniqueness of you. That's what rocks the world. That's what shines the light. That's what brings us closer to spirit, because that's what you're expressing is your spirit. And many of you have expressed your spirit through these beautiful flowers, which has been our theme for bulletin board art this season. And guess what? I went to the post office, so I have some more, my friends. And so we're going to do a little bit of show and tell, which means I'm going to be rocking the reading glasses. See, I've gotten a lot more comfortable with that. So let us see what we have here. Oh, I have something that is from Maple Ridge, BC. I'm just going to do this and protect that person's privacy. But look, there's already a flower on the outside. Have you noticed that there's a real love this year of flowers that sort of lead with their center and then petals drop behind? And I wonder, as I do that, as I imagine myself as one of those flowers, if that's a heart opening. Maybe it is. Maybe it is. Maybe that's just a heart opener this summer. Let's see what's here. It's from Leonie. Hello, Leonie. So look at this. Leonie has sent 2 flowers. One, this is her own photograph here. I assume Leonie, because you've signed it. Thank you for signing your art. And then also in here, oh, look. What glorious colors. What happy flowers. And I love the way you've done the background here. It just makes all the flowers really pop. And it feels so much like summer. and she calls it the English Country Garden, and she did it with Tombow pens and gel pens. Leone, I love the way you're acknowledging yourself as an artist here. I love that you're sharing the medium. I love that you've named your piece and that you have signed it on the back. And thank you so much for letting me know that you really enjoy and look forward to the BTS every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. That really means a lot to me, and I really appreciate knowing that. Okay, now we have something from Randy. Hey, Randy. It's so funny, Randy. Your city name is a city name here in Ontario, too. So I was like, oh, this is from Canada as well. But nope, it's from Virginia. And here we go. Pretty, look. Oh, isn't that a wonderful flower? And I love the way you framed it here on paper. What a lovely way to give it some weight and some importance. I so love it. Oh, and she's named it too, A Thought That Wandered By. Ah, we have poets in the audience. Alexis sent us a flower poem, and I wonder if we should do poetry one season. What do you think? Well, you're free to send me poetry, actually, anytime you like. Oh, look at this too. Pretty. I so appreciate the effort and the beauty and the love that people are putting into this Bulletin Board Art Project. Hi, Brianna. Now, Brianna is in my hood. Nice to get something from a neighbor. So we have a lovely card from Brianna. And inside, oh, look at this. A little flower for you for the BTS Bulletin Board Garden. Look at that. I did get the sweet pea seeds. Brianna, did you see that episode? I'm pretty sure that I shared it on a BTS. What a nice idea to cut it out in the shape of the flower. And can you see that there's a bit of sparkle here to the center of the flower? You know, that would also, I'm looking for my journal. I'm like, that would look so lovely glued onto a journal. Thank you, Brianna. And thank you so much for those sweet pea seeds. And now one from Anne. Anne, you are also from Virginia. So that's two Virginians sending flowers today. And that is a real treat. Thank you. Oh, and this is so nice. Anne watches the BTS. She's a member of the studio. She's taken classes in the academy. And she made this beautiful, gorgeous, cool flower inspired by some collages that I've shown before. And look at, oh, I love the colors. Do you see already what I'm talking about when I say that when we create from our heart, that something very unique and individual happens? I mean, look at the beautiful bouquet. This isn't just the bouquet of flowers that has been sent to me and to all of us at the BTS. This is a beautiful bouquet of people. That's what this is. This represents the unique creative spirit of each of these women. You can just see the individuality in their vision, in their color choices, in their medium choices, in the flowers they pick, in the way they express them. Like for me, that is everything. That is everything. So I thank you to everybody for sharing something that they've really created with their unique vision, including Janet. Hey, Janet, you were just asking me if I'd gotten your flower. And guess what? I did, all the way from California. Look at this beautiful card. And I'm just reading the message. And I just want to say thank you, Janet. And I'm just so glad that what I share makes a difference to you and that it changes things, that it inspires. Thank you so much for these words. They mean a lot to me. And look, pretty, pretty, pretty. Oh, ha, ha. Live the life you love. Yes, please. Let's take that as inspiration today. Thank you, Janet, for reminding us. Live the life you love. Start now. Do it today. And I know that sounds like a big ask. Live the life you love. But let's start somewhere small and practical. Just take 5 minutes. 5 minutes to write in your journal about what the life you love would look like. And 5 minutes is an amazing, I mean, if you've been in Journal Club, you know, amazing discoveries can be made in 5 minutes. So just put on a timer, set your clock, and just go. What would a life I love look like? 5 minutes. And then once you've done that, pick something, some energy, some action, some moment to take action on. So, you know, if a life you love involves flowers, then buy yourself a flower today, or see if you can pick one from your garden, or go on an exploration in your neighborhood and take a picture of flowers. If life you love involves friendship, then write a letter or call someone and set a coffee date. If a life you love includes drawing and painting and visual arts, then give yourself 20 minutes to draw in your journal or get out the paints for an hour or two this weekend. Take something that you've learned and take action on it. It doesn't have to be a huge, big deal, but it will be. When you start to taste what you love and you understand it better and you see that it's possible to have it in your life, more and more you will start, that inner compass will start to retune. Instead of being like all haywire from the busy, from the other people's voices, from all the opinions that you see, all those, that your inner critic, it's going haywire. The more you just get a taste of, what, wait, drawing? Hold on a second, drawing, yes, that's my inner compass is saying yes. You know, more of that, please. You know, or, actually dressing up, I love it, I forgot. Nobody dresses up these days. I don't really have anywhere to dress up, but this morning I got up and instead of just putting on that old t-shirt, I put on a shirt I loved and I feel different, yes. Inner compass says yes. Little things make all the difference. They get you started. They retune your compass. They show you what's possible. And they get you to enjoy the life that you love. Not in 10 years, not in 5 years, not in 2 weeks. Today. Today! So make today the day. Okay, next week, it's going to be the last week of the BTS for the spring-summer season. On Friday, I'm going to go live. So I hope you'll join me for that. I really, really do. And maybe I should have saved the pictures for then. Well, I'm glad I shared them today. So next Friday, 8:30 a.m. EST. And Shannon told me a secret that if you come to my page, the fastest way to get there is creativelivingtv.ca, and it'll take you to my YouTube page, and you'll see the subscribe button. I hope you've already subscribed. If not, do so now. Make sure you never miss out. But beside the subscribe button, there's also a little bell. If you click on that bell, it'll send you a notice that says, Jamie's gone live. And then that way you'll know to run on over and be sure to take part. And this is a great opportunity. If you have questions for me, if you have things you wonder about, if you're stuck on something and you could use some help, if you're curious how I do something or how I get through something or about something behind the scenes in the studio that maybe I haven't addressed, then ask me. I would love to have that conversation with you. And if I know something and it can help, I'll share it. So I hope you'll join me live next Friday. I'm so glad you joined me today, and I will see you on Monday. I am ever so much better at creating spring gardens, but one of the joys of midsummer is this star of billion. Just the name is a wonderful delight.